Okay, so good morning everyone and welcome back in today's class. So we are on the day number 26. Okay, it's a good journey going on till now. And if I talk about specifically for the yesterday topic, we covered about the import set and the transform map. From the practical experience, from the practical part, yes, this is very important because everyone, either you are a consultant, either you are a developer, or either you are an architect, you guys need to be think on that, how I can bring my data into the service now. Okay, from the interview perspective, they will, in the interview, it has been asked that what is the purpose of the transform map, number one. Then what is the purpose of the CoalSec in the transform map? That is the important point. And one or two liners on that particular topic will be enough to answer, because it has been observed during the interview which I took that people don't know that what is the purpose of the CoalSec here. Okay, today we are going to become start our new topic. I not the new topic, just overview of the previous topic, and we'll start the new topic today. Okay, so this is the one part, that how I can transform my data from one place to another place. Okay, let me log in here. I'm using your instance as well, because in today's topic I'm going to be cover a new topic on that front. So you says that Atul, I want to import the data in service now from any of the way, but in the beginning you told that we need to get some kind of a template on the place, then we can do that part. Okay, now I'll show you another way to import the data into service now, that is called the what I will do. I'll go to Farah instance and I'll open this user record. Suppose I want to move this user record from this particular instance to this particular instance. Okay, now what I will do, I open, okay, let it be load quickly. Okay, yeah. And right click on the top on the context menu. Okay, and export in the XML. I say export in the XML. I done that part. I got the XML here. Now, if I want to move this record into my next instance, into this, what I'll do, I'll go here, same place, user admin, open the user table here. Okay, and what I'll do, I'll just click here on the user ID. Okay. And go to the import. When you click on the import, sorry, go to the import XML, this place. I click on the import XML. Where, from where you want to do the XML, I click on the choose file. And go to my download section here and click on the open and click on the upload here. And my record has been created into the system. Atul, no company has been mentioned here, all these things, and in this same manner it has been there. Now the question come, Atul, if we want to go or we are using the XML only, then why you suggest a transform map yesterday, a very big topic, a very big process perspective. Okay, we use our these things, what I can say, XML part when we want to do the data for a set of things. Okay, I am importing, let me open a notepad here. If you remember when we started this class, okay, I said we have an environment thing. One is called the dev, one is called the test, and one is called the production. Dev means I am bringing my data initially here. From dev to test, I'm again repeating, from dev to test, if I want to move my data, I'm not saying move to my configuration. If from dev to test I want to move my data, then I use the XML specifically, or I use the Excel as well. Okay, from test to prod, if I want to move my data, I will use the same technique here. But if I want to move my configuration, my customization, my code, then we use the update set. So today we will do these two things. Number one, we move the data and we move the update set. So this is the one of the way that you can move the data through the XML part. Okay. Now one more point, let me click on the user ID here and click on the import. Yesterday we saw that we need to build up a template for the import data. Click on the import. Okay. And from here you can download the template as well. What you say, if you want to insert any record, you want to update any record. See, transform map is much preferable because in the transform map you can see the error logs as well. But in the XML or Excel import, it is tough to debug that areas. Okay, so that is the thing. And we do the XML or the Excel import in case we know only data is moving and that data is already verified data. If you say I want to insert the records, okay, click here. Do you want to create an Excel template to enter the data? Yes, I want that. Include all fields in the template. Suppose in the user table I have 200 fields. Do you want all? Yes or no? If you say yes, it will ask you the thing. So I put the create Excel template for me. When I click on this, it is creating a Excel file for me, which we created yesterday. I'll show you here. Download. And let me open this. It is little heavy one. It take that maybe it go for the 1 or 2 MB approximately because it includes that data as well sometime. Okay, it's been loading. In the meantime, what will happen that when this Excel sheet will be downloaded, okay, what we will do, we will make some correction and we will upload the data again into the system. Okay, this is the another way given by ServiceNow. The only benefit by using this technique is that you are getting a standard template. It is too heavy because it is downloading multiple things for you. Let me go on here in Farhaz one. Let's see what is downloading. Okay. Quick win I need here. So let me try to download. Import. And insert, yes, include all fields in the template. Yes. Okay, it has been downloaded. Let me open this. So now we will see this. Let it be open. It's a 3 MB file, so it's take little time to do that part. Yes. So what ServiceNow say that if you want to do the import, I am giving you the guide as well here. Okay, like this. So you can read these things. If you go to the page one, see, these are my complete fields. How many fields? I have 54 fields. And yesterday what we did, we just downloaded 5 or 4 fields only. See, 54 fields. Okay, now let me show if it is available here. Company, business impact. Yeah, so you can see here. This is giving the default value as well. Business impact, yes or no? Let me go on this. Enable multiple authentication. Yes or no? Okay. Gender, male and female. This is the reason that this Excel sheet is little heavy. But the biggest benefit is that there's a no spelling mistake. You know, business impact is high, but how this high has been mentioned? 2-high. If I'm a user, I'll just mention high. And I upload this record, it will be fail for me. True, yes or no? these things. So by using this template as well, you can import the data. Okay, so you can see a lot of things are there.
Excuse me, Atul.
Yes, Farah.
The best way to
transform map.
Yeah.
Download this Excel for the template perspective and use the transform map always.
Okay.
That is the best one. Because this is the only good if you know that your data is verified one. There's a no mistake in the data. So that you can quickly upload the data in the system.
Okay.
And transform map, basically what we do, suppose, let's take example. Every Monday, new people join my company. Okay. And it is tough for my HR team or my IT team to create the 100 accounts every day. So what they did, they created a template like this. And then they create a scheduled job for the same. That Monday evening, 6 o'clock, HR will share the data with me in this particular format. And then my record will be created and updated in the system. Okay, so ways to do that part, but I always prefer to go for the transform map. That is the good place because it gives you the error records as well. Okay. So this is one of the point which I want to discuss now. Let's see. I want to do the for the update. Okay. Let me go here. Okay. Let's see. I want to do for the update here. Nothing is changed. Okay. I click create Excel file. Now what it will do, it will record the download the records for me as well. So that you can change the required records for the required. Okay. Now if I download, it become more than 4 MB. Okay. So in the insert, you will get the simple format like this. But in the update, you will get the records as well so that you can make a required correction. I want to change my middle name. I want to put some middle name. I want to change my country code. I want to change. So use the exist data and upload it into the system. That is the only difference by using these two methods. Then you can go here and import your file. That's not an issue. Let do this thing. Active true. Yes. Business impact. Critical. Calendar integration. Outlook. Company. SR. Cost center, I don't want. Date format, I don't want. Email, department email, I need. learn@grow.com. Okay. Employee number. With first name. Learn. Gender. Is basically, I'll say male. Okay. Leave it. I don't record anything. Okay, prefix you want, doctor. Last login, last name, group. Name. Telephone notification, anything you want to put, you can put it here. Okay, VIP user. Let me save this now. Okay. The same Excel I can use in my transform map as well. That is the one thing. Or I can use at this place as well. Okay. CC user, open it and upload. It's uploading my data into the system now. So this is called the utility here. File uploader is a utility given by ServiceNow. It is kind of a code written by ServiceNow already, and this standardized call as a utilities. Like open the record in the PDF format, it is a utility. Read the Excel file, it is a utility for from the given by ServiceNow.